So now that we are able to shoot, we should be able to give damage to other objects. So to do that, let's create a new script in the shared folder. Let's call it Destructable. And open it up in Mono Behavior. I'm sorry, in Mono Develop, of course. Then remove this and add a new field. Hit points. So this will be the number of hit points the destructible item has. Then let's create a new event and let's call it undeath, and a new event on damage received. So two events which occur when the player dies, or the destructible dies, or when it receives damage. Then we create a new private variable, damage taken, amount of damage which has been taken by the destructible. So let's create a method which will give us, which will tell us how much hit points we still have, hit points remaining. Get. This will be the hit points minus damage taken. So that's the number of hit points we still have left. Let's make boolean is alive. And this will return, of course this should return hit points minus damage taken. Return hit points remaining, the one we just created. Larger than zero. Cool. Now let's create two overridable methods. Virtual void die when the player dies. Then we're gonna check is live. So if the player is already dead, we escape here. If undeath not equals null. It. So when this simply checks if the player is still alive. Now let's create take damage, public void, virtual as well. We want to override it. Take damage, and we're going to take an amount of damage. And we're going to say damage taken, add the amount to the damage taken, and if the on damage received event not equals null, on damage received, and then we can say if hit points remaining is less or equal to null, say die. Probably want to reset the player as well, so then we can say public void reset. Then we say damage taken. So. Alright, this obviously is a piece of code which will be executed on the server only when we switch to multiplayer. Now we have the destructible class. We're gonna switch over to the projectile. And now we are just hitting everything. So here we're gonna check if the collider we're entering has the component of destructible. So var destructible is other transform get component. If destructible equals null, well, we hit it something we cannot destroy, so we just return it. Otherwise, we say destructible take damage, and then the amount of damage from this projectile. Now, let's create a new. So this is the destructible, Let's create a new script. Let's call it help. Yeah, help should be okay. And we're not gonna inherit money behavior, but we're gonna inherit the destructible. And now we have the override methods available, die, take damage. So let's check die. We override the die method, that's what I mean. Then we just say, well, print, we died. And then we also can say override, take damage. Print remaining, hit points remaining. Okay, now let's create a new cube. There it is. Let's make it larger so that we are able to hit it. There we go. And we're gonna add the health component to it. We're gonna say it's got 5 hit points. Now, oh, I missed. I hit it once, it says remaining 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We died. So it says the it started with a 5 when we hit it, because I took the base method after the print. So if you're going to do it like this, it will immediately say 4 after the first hit. There we go. Okay, that works pretty well. Let's see. Well, let's leave it for now and see you in the next movie. And bye bye.